In the headlines, a French citizen counteracts negative publicity about Dominica as a tourist destination, as the DDA promotes the destination as a favorite of French tourists. The Ministry of Housing places Erica's impact on the housing stock in the region of over $200,000, and the Hotel and Tourism Association continues to search for the right strategy to end vagrancy's impact on tourism. I am Lorraine Graham Carter with the Channel 5 News. Details coming up. First up in the news, a French citizen is doing her part to dismiss public perception that the island has been so damaged by Storm Erica that it cannot welcome tourists. Katia Dutrier of Martinique wants potential French visitors to know that Dominica is open for tourism business. Katia's parents own Sunset Bay Club and Seaside Resort in Batterley, which has been closed since the August 27th storm. They are working on reopening this month. Katia says she started promoting the destination through her own efforts on the heels of the tourist season.
Last week I went back and I got a whole week from Galleria, a stand, for free to promote the destination. Not only for Sunset Bay Club, because Sunset Bay Club is not Dominica. Sunset Bay Club is part of Dominica. We are part of the tourism business. And what I went and tell the people is that, make them clear, is that the whole island didn't get destroyed. It was localized and Dominica is again ready and in a situation to welcome tourists. So there is no reason not to come and visit us. So in the meantime, of course, I put the message that we are going to be open for business again on the 22nd. And actually, during the days of promotion, I got already reservations as of the 23rd and 24th.
The venue where she sets up her stall is La Galleria, a shopping mall located near Martinique's capital, Fort-de-France. It is known for hosting trade shows.
Actually, yesterday had people from Pointe-Michel that live in Martinique that said that so many people that call on them for information, they just think that Dominique is no more. It's just like an after-war kind of scenery. And yeah, we realize that lots of people actually think that Dominica has been entirely destroyed. So we really need to get that word out, and we will continue working on this to get this word out by the radios, the national radios of Martinique in particular, because I live there. So yeah, we have been doing that.
Meantime, Discover Dominica Authority has planned a radio public awareness campaign for Martinique and Guadeloupe to strengthen the message that Dominica is open to visitors.
DDA expects to partner with the private sector to implement that promotion in the French islands. This comes on the heels of a recent press trip here by French media. DDA hosted 12 journalists from Guadeloupe and Martinique from October 7 to 10 as they provided coverage on the country's storm recovery efforts. The trip focused on the state of the tourism industry and agricultural sector. While here, they interviewed Agriculture Minister Johnson Drago and Director of Tourism Colin Piper. They were taken on tourist attractions including Trafalgar Falls, Wharton Waven Sulphur Spas, Indian River, and Kalinago Barana Oti. Tourism authorities hope that the French media reports will inform potential visitors in Martinique and Guadeloupe that Dominica is ready and able to welcome visitors to its shores. Majority of visitor arrivals are from the neighboring French islands. In 2014, Dominica welcomed 14,822 Guadeloupean visitors and 6,482 from Martinique. The French market makes up 25 to 29% of the country's visitor arrivals. From October to December, stayover numbers increase. The French media also met representatives from the Division of Culture, Dominica Hotel and Tourism Association, and Kalinago Chief Charles Williams. The group of journalists came from the Guadeloupe and Martinique Premier TV stations, France Antilles Guadeloupe and Martinique, Canal 10 TV Guadeloupe, ATV Martinique, Nouvelle Semaine, and the Journalists Union of Guadeloupe Media.
Still in tourism, the Dominica Hotel and Tourism Association is hoping that a strategy in the making will put an end to vagrancy as a problem during the tourist season.
DHTA has been working with a national subcommittee on vagrancy to address vagrancy in the city streets. Cabinet is reportedly yet to approve a white paper on vagrancy presented by that committee, since there are aspects in the plan to be clarified. DHDA's president-elect, Ariane Perriman, told Channel 5 News the association has been working with government on the document and awaits word on the status of their action.
But the plan has different phases that is going to not only assist at the immediate level with the vagrancy issues, but also we have been working with Dr. Benjamin in formulating a long-term plan. So it will no longer be an issue. We're hoping that eventually it'll be a strategy. So really and truly, it's not the DHTA's making a decision on this. We are basically facilitating the process. We are not experts on the vagrancy issue, so we're really leaning on the Ministry of Health, on Dr. Benjamin, to give us a footpath as to how that issue should be led.
While the Small Charges Act looks at vagrancy as an offense liable to imprisonment for 1 month, the White Paper on Vagrancy considers a more lenient approach to address the situation.
So in the initial stage, there's going to be an encouragement to have the vagrants be relocated to the hospital as a day clinic program, with the intention of doing an assessment of each vagrant. With that assessment, a plan will be put forward as to a relocation or rehabilitation program for each individual person. Every vagrant needs to be assessed.
In other major news, assessments of the housing stock continue in the wake of Storm Erica.
The housing sector has taken an over $236,000 blow from Tropical Storm Erica. This is the official preliminary estimate coming from assessments done by the Ministry of Housing. Assessments conducted focused on Petit Savan, Pichley, Good Hope, Bath Estate, Dubique, Campbell, Koulibistri, Saint-Sauveur, Petit Soufriere, and critical areas of Grand Bay, Dalis, Boetica, Laplane, Collioure, and Grand Four.
And we know of the communities of Petit Savan and Dubique, Collioure, and Koulibistri in particular, where a lot of housing damage has happened. Following up from the rapid assessment that was done, the Ministry of Housing has set up four teams of officers who have gone out throughout the communities, throughout the country, and conducted a more detailed damage assessment. And in all of these two categories, the special disaster area and the other critical areas, we have come up with a figure of 457 houses thereabouts that have been seriously damaged.
Jules says assessments have also been taking place in Forbauer, Lubier, and Benaravine, Canefield. Over 200 homes have either been damaged or destroyed at Petit Savan, the community hardest hit by Storm Erica.
So that figure of 457 damaged houses will in fact increase. With all of that being said, some of these houses, some level of repairs can be undertaken. But in a lot of cases, some houses are badly damaged that it will have to be demolished. And well, we still await a firm decision on the actual evacuation of Petit Savan and Dubique. And if that is so, whereas in these communities there are some houses that seem intact, but if the communities are deemed to be evacuated, then the houses that are still intact can no longer be occupied, and so the owners and occupants will also have to be treated with in terms of their housing needs.
No houses built under government's Housing Revolution program have been damaged. Leading up to general elections, government had promised to continue a vision to increase the housing stock with construction of 1,500 homes in this term. What now happens to that target post-Storm Erica?
even before the government instituted the policy of construction of 1,500 homes, it was already clear that we have a housing deficit in Dominica. And that was government's effort at positively impacting that deficit, to reduce it. And that program has been on stream, yes, but it is clear now that with the impact of Tropical Storm Erica, our housing deficit has grown. In light of that, the government is really working assiduously to identify some safer residential areas as far as the proximity to water courses and other hazards.
Building materials are among the country's most urgent needs. Idona John Baptist, Channel 5 News.
In more news now, Prime Minister Roosevelt Scarrett has dismissed statements that he is a person of interest to any foreign government or organization.
During a press conference of the United Workers' Party last week, it was disclosed that Chinese billionaire Ng Lap Seng was arrested in a United Nations bribery investigation by the FBI in the United States. During a recent function in Macau, Prime Minister Scarrett was seen with Ng Lap Seng, a UN diplomat from the Dominican Republic, Francis Lorenzo, and former Antiguan diplomat, John Ash. There, the two men were also arrested during the investigations.
I have no association whatsoever with this matter, none. And there is no authority in this world that is interested in Roosevelt Scarrett in any undue manner, none whatsoever. I mean, if you should ask Mr. Linton about his information, present the facts to you, to make some assertions without the facts. Well, which facts? So because somebody you know somebody or somebody knows you, then all of a sudden you are also guilty. You go to international conferences, people are invited. I am not the one who invited them. The organizers invite them. You will always take photographs. There'll be photographs, whether it is a family, what they call a family photograph, or there'll be media taking photographs of the event and carrying it. What is wrong with that? So are you saying that now the UN Secretary General must go and explain all of this because somebody who is associated with the UN was arrested?
Scarrett says a Dominican should not immediately jump to the wrong conclusion when accusations like these are made.
I was invited, for example, to Macau by the UN agency to speak on issues of sustainable development and South-South cooperation. The Prime Minister of Grenada was also invited. He could not be there at the time. The other Prime Ministers were invited. So what is the issue? Why must I come to account because somebody else has been arrested? Everybody must stand on his 2 feet and face the courts and face his charges and then respond appropriately. But to say that there's been, I mean, I've heard the opposition making a case for this thing. But how can you hold me responsible for somebody's actions? Why should I be the one to explain why somebody else has been arrested?
The Prime Minister was addressing the media during a press conference to wrap up a solidarity visit by Grenada's Prime Minister, Dr. Keith Mitchell. Andrea Louis, Channel 5 News.
Coming up, hear from organizers of the second annual Creole in the Streets and Astaban's contribution to post-Erica relief efforts. Thank you for staying with us. The people of Grenada continue to help Dominica in its post-Erica recovery efforts.
During a visit to Dominica on Friday, Grenada's Prime Minister, Dr. Keith Mitchell, said Grenadian artists are organizing a special day of artistic performances for Dominica, an event scheduled for November. In late August, Grenada was among the first countries to send relief supplies to Dominica. A delegation consisting of Grenada's health minister, deputy commissioner of police, an engineer and pathologist was also on island.
The cultural artists, the sporting community in Grenada, all concerned and the people have asked me to say to you that in addition to things that we have done and we are doing, they're declaring November 7th as a special day of artistic performances on behalf of the people of Dominica. And they asked me to make sure that to invite you just for a day. We're not gonna take him for too long, just one day. Because I think it will help the publicity and the success of that particular event.
The Grenadian Prime Minister said that during times of disaster, regional groupings come together to assist countries on moving forward past the tragedy.
Yes, I'm here representing my country because we've had the experiences of having to face a disaster of enormous proportion. But I'm also representing the rest of my colleagues at the OECS. So if you have not seen them in actual physical presence, your spirit is here with us today because it's a family. And they all express their sense of support and commitment to the development of Dominica and the recovery of your country in all aspects.
Dr. Mitchell cautioned Dominicans that the road to recovery is long and challenging. He was speaking from experience of the damage caused to Grenada in 2004 following the passage of Hurricane Ivan.
It is when things happen to you, you get to know your true friends. Grenada found that out in 2004. Your country, your prime minister, the rest of the OECS family, they were there with us. They bled with us. I got up on the morning of 2004, in September, and when I looked around and I saw a whole country on the ground, I don't think anyone wants to ever have that feeling. Grenadians as a whole understand what is taking place in Dominica.
Prime Minister Dr. Keith Mitchell was addressing the media after a visit to heavily affected communities on Friday.
In more news, the National Development Foundation of Dominica Limited anticipates major support from the public for its second annual Creole in the Streets Expo. The NDFD launched the Creole in the Streets Exposition on Monday. Public Relations Officer of the event, Carrie Charles Thomas, says they are targeting over 50 participants for the event on Friday, 23 October.
This is an opportunity for citizens to see what is being produced in Dominica, to meet the entrepreneurs, and to sample and purchase their product. We are also appealing to the general public to come and support the NDFD, come and support the entrepreneurs of Dominica, and come and celebrate our independence. Celebrate independence with us as well as we showcase services of our clients and some of our partners.
Executive Director at NDFD, Cletus Joseph, described the Creole in the Streets as an activity with a difference. He says it gives Dominicans the opportunity to showcase their creativity.
The local resources available and then use our skills and human resources available to create products and services that the wider community deserves, and hence we can really make a difference in our economic environment.
The event will be held under the theme Nation Building Continues Through the Restoration of our MSME Sector. Creole in the Streets was initially launched in October last year. The event will take place on Great Marlborough Street from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. In other stories, J. Astefans and Company donates over $200,000 towards post-Erica relief efforts. Immediately after the storm, the locally owned company collected over $58,000 for relief aid. The company additionally sought further assistance from their partners, resulting in 28 partners coming on board. With the funds collected and donated from partners, the company was able to hand over a check of $250,000 to the government of Dominica. To date, the company continues in its effort to raise more funds for the relief effort. It is expected that more partners will join in the coming weeks. And finally, a fast food company's hope of handing over 200 school bags to four primary schools around the island was washed away by Erica. The intent of KFC Book Bag Project, which began last year, was to provide every primary school student with bags and stationery. Unfortunately, marketing personnel with the company says most of the bags were damaged during the storm, leaving them with the only option of delivering to two schools. 83 bags were given to the students of the Benz and Wharton Waven primary schools last week. The initiative began in 2014 with the Concord and Loda Primary School and a summer school in the Kalinago Territory. There, 36 students received bags and stationery. Next year, KFC hopes to give priority to schools which missed out this year. Your sports highlights coming up next.
We begin with football. Excitement gripped fans at Benjamin's Park and Windsor Park Sports Stadium last weekend as week two of the DFA Premier League kicked off. The first match saw Sagicor with a 4-1 victory over their rival Sineman as Delbert Hazel scored one for Sineman in the first half. South East replied with Marlon Phillips finding the back of the net for a penalty shot, Sydney Lockhart adding the second goal, Josley Prince the third, and Kevin Lawrence the final one in extra time. Game 2 on Saturday saw defending champions Exodus taking vengeance on Icons with a 6-0 defeat. Following the first game of the season, Exodus saw a landslide victory as Kelrick Walters scored 5 goals in the first half, giving his team their first win of the season. Football fans gathered at Windsor Park Stadium on Sunday to witness the renowned Randolph Pelletier as he scored 4 goals for Bath Estate.
Well, my strategy I used tonight was speed. And because the defenders, they're not that fast. And when you're playing in the stadium, there's a lot of space. So my team decided that we were going to use my speed against the slower defenders.
And after being reduced to 9 men because of 2 red cards, Jamie Parolin scored 1 goal for Steel Bombers. Bath Estate won their second match of the league. Game 2 saw Dublin Football Club beating Harlem 2-1. It was Dublin's second win of the league. An Olympic world champion Usain Bolt to make a retirement decision after the 2016 Olympics in Rio. Bolt says he has been discussing retirement plans with his coach but hasn't decided if it will be after the Olympic Games or at the World Championships the next year. The renowned sprinter will begin preparations for the Olympic Games in Rio this week. He plans on successfully defending his Olympic title for a second time. Grenada's Prime Minister and Chairman of the Subcommittee on CARICOM for cricket, the Honourable Keith Mitchell, describes West Indies cricket management as ineffective. A former cricketer himself, Mitchell says he's appalled at the way in which the sport has declined.
The management of West Indies cricket is that the operation is very dysfunctional. Some institution that has been at the helm of world sport at a certain period has been in decline for 20-something years without a stoppage of decline. If I am governing Grenada.
In domino, the top 3 scorers in game 1 of the Kubuli Chebe South 3-hand domino league were simple with 87 those 3 points, Green City 78 those 3 points, and Unbreakable with 74 those 2 points. Round 2 on Sundays, in Sunday's game saw the top 3 with Hood Dem at 82 those 3 points, Giant 78 those 3 points, Remix 75 those 3 points, Rabbit Hole 75 those but 2 points. The 13 teams qualifying for the league so far, Martian, Barbie, GMs, Rabbit Hole, Remix, Attackers, Giants, CFD, Simple, Green City, Homeboys, Hood Dem and 007. That's all the sports highlights for now. Join us next time.
A tropical wave is expected to move across our area by late Tuesday into Wednesday. Your weather report coming up.
Good evening, viewers, and welcome to tonight's weather broadcast. We start off with today's infrared satellite imagery, which showed a tropical wave just east of the Lesser Antilles. We now move on to today's visible satellite imagery, which showed occasional cloudy skies across Dominica and the rest of the islands during the course of the day. Today's radar imagery indicated scattered showers across Dominica, mainly during the afternoon. Tonight's weather is expected to be partly cloudy with a few scattered showers. And tomorrow, the weather is expected to become increasingly cloudy with some scattered showers as the tropical wave moves across the Lesser Antilles. Sea conditions tomorrow will be moderate in open water, with waves picking up to 7 feet. And our 72-hour projection puts yet another tropical wave east of the Lesser Antilles. And looking ahead, instability associated with the tropical wave is expected to produce occasional cloudy skies with scattered showers into Thursday. And across the Lesser Antilles tomorrow, mostly cloudy skies with scattered showers can be expected across most of the islands. And on the international scene, there's a chance of rain in New York, chance of thunderstorm activity in Miami and Caracas, and fair to partly cloudy skies in London and Beijing. The sun will rise tomorrow at 5:57 a.m. and will set at 5:47 p.m. For further information, visit our website at weather.gov.dm or call the weather hotline at 447-5555. Thank you for joining us this evening. Have a good night.
That's news. The headlines again. A French citizen counteracts negative publicity about Dominica as a tourist destination, as the DDA promotes the destination as a favorite of French tourists. The Ministry of Housing places Erica's impact on the housing stock in the region of over $200,000. And the Hotel and Tourism Association continues to search for the right strategy to end vagrancy's impact on tourism. Let us know what you think via email at news@mappin2k4.com. You can also access our past newscasts on our Mappin News YouTube page. On behalf of the production team, I am Lorraine Graham Carter. Thank you for watching and join us tomorrow.